Remember, we're helping you learn Linux.
Hello and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallet and we're going to concentrate today not just on creating users in Ansible, but looking at ways that we can pass variables from the command line so we're not stuck with a static user. So if we go through and just take a look at a YAML file that I've got within my directory here, the user.yml. So here we've got creating a user. Now this is great where we want to create the user Joe, but I don't necessarily, every time I want to create a different user, have to come down and edit the name. So this is good, however, it's not as good as it can be. We can actually start passing variables through instead of having a statically assigned name, much as we'd be used to within other scripting languages. So I can then go through and then in place of my hard-coded name, we can go through then and in our double quotes, put our brace brackets, making sure there's no additional spaces between the quotes and the double brace brackets. And we can then decide on a variable to use. So I'm just putting in an uppercase user underscore name. The variables are case sensitive, but it doesn't matter whether they're uppercase or lowercase. So there we go, we've got a variable. Now this variable can be provided in many mechanisms. We can use vars within our play, or we can use host or group variables. But we'll look at how we can pass a variable through from the command line. Again, we don't want to have to be editing our files for this to take place. So we just run our ordinary Ansible playbook command with the option minus E for our extra variables. And then in quotes, put the variable that we want. So user underscore name equals, and Fred is always a good choice, isn't it, for a variable. And then don't forget to throw the playbook at the end. Hit the enter key and then wait for it to chug through. And then as it goes through, we should be able to see, there you go, our user being created. So that's all well and good. We've been able to create our user. And of course, we can delete our user in very much the same mechanism. We can check that our user is there. If we go through and use the getent command, looking at our password database, and then go through looking for our Fred user, we can see, there you go, Fred is in place. But as I say, as well as creating our user accounts using this mechanism, we can use exactly the same mechanism to go through and delete our user accounts. So let's go through and just take a look at editing the file again. So we can go through and open up the user YAML. So when we've got our task here to create our new user, and we can see there's roughly 6 lines. So I can go through and copy those 6 lines and paste them in again afterwards. Now, of course, we might as well go through and change the name of the task from to create to remove. And of course, I don't need all of these properties, but we might have to make some other changes. So we certainly don't need the password, don't need the create home. And of course, we don't want our state to be present. We want it to be absent. So we can go through and put that value in. Next, we're going to make sure we remove the home directory, the mail spool file, and any cron file. So a bit like our user del minus r. So we can put our remove and equals true. Now, if we left it like this, it would be okay, but we create our user account and we remove our user account. So it doesn't make that much sense. But we can use a little bit of logic, and that's where the Ansible when clause comes in. We can go through making sure that the when clause is part of our task, so all lined up with the name and the module. And we can go through then and think of another variable name. So we might have user create. And then we use a double equals. So we can go through and then specify is equal to, and then a string value of no. There you go. That task is only going to run when user create equals no. We can go through and paste that same line into our create new user task. And then we can make sure that this task only runs when user create has a value of yes. So now we can look at passing two variables through, the username and the value of user create at our command line. So if we go back and just take a look at where we've specified this. So this is where we were creating our user. But let's now go through and add that additional variable. So our user underscore create equals no. With that done, then we're ready to go. And we should find that as it executes, we skip the first task to create the user, because that only runs when user create has a value of yes. So we see we skip the creation of our user account. We're now looking at removing the user, and we have gone ahead and that has changed. So this is just a really cool way that we can start using a little bit of logic within our playbook and using variables.
All that is left to say is thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this, then you are probably sadder than I first thought. For more of this drivel, please subscribe, like and comment to @theurbanpenguin.